I swear that's great, miss, great, miss, great, miss.
You look into my eyes, you can see what I see. If you can say the world won't be the same without me, then we call that greatness,
and that's a blessing. But wait a second, look, while we on the subject, let me ask a question.
Hello and welcome to the Uzzi Sports Show. I'm Jared Valluzzi, and Long Island High School football season has wrapped up, and I think I could speak for a lot of people when I say it was really special. And today we're going to be taking a look at the top offensive players on Long Island throughout this past year. And let's get right into it. Let's start off with the quarterback position. And in some people's eyes, maybe the most valuable player on Long Island, it's Dante Torres of St. Anthony's. And Torres had a sensational senior year, over 3,000 yards through the air, 32 touchdowns, which was a school record. He also added 13 TDs on the ground, and he was such an improviser, making so many people miss and having some tremendous, unreal throws on the run. He was truly one of the best players in the state, and he'll be playing football at Fordham next year. And now, let's stay in Suffolk County. We're going to go to Braden Stahl of Smithtown West. And the Bulls, they were in a conference where it was all about ground and pound. But they knew if they wanted to win games, they would have to air it out. And Braden Stahl really rose to the occasion as the junior gunslinger absolutely lit it up. Over 2,600 yards through the air, 29 TDs. Stahl was very efficient for a Smithtown West team that scored a ton of points. And now for my final quarterback on this list, it's the Hansen Award winner, and it's Brady Clark of Bayport Blue Point. And the Phantoms, they were looking to win their first ever LIC in school history, and Clark helped them deliver it, as he was truly an amazing quarterback, whether it was running the ball or passing the ball. Clark really stepped up in these big-time games, as he was one of the most accurate passers on Long Island. Now let's head over to the running back position. And we just talked about the Hansen Award winner. Let's talk about the Thorpe Award winner. Stevie Fennell of Garden City certainly has to be on this list. His combination of strength and speed was on display just about every time he stepped out onto the field. And because of how Garden City was so dominant, he didn't see the field a lot in the second half. But he saved his best performance for last. Over 300 yards on the ground against Bellport, he added 4 touchdowns, and he led Garden City to another Long Island title. And speaking of amazing Nassau County running backs, we're going to go to Tommaso Ramos of Farmingdale. One of the shiftiest players in the state, Ramos had an LIC record, 437 all-purpose yards. He led the Dalers to the big Long Island title over Ward Melville. And you have to think, Ramos is one of the shiftiest players in all of New York. He's committed to Stony Brook for lacrosse right now, but that really might change after what he did during his senior year. Watch out for the talented running back to maybe commit somewhere for football. And now, final running back on the list, we're going to go out to Suffolk County, and it's the sophomore sensation, Kyle Messina. And Messina, he's got the speed, the vision, a ton of agility. He's got to be one of the best sophomore prospects in the state, and certainly was one of the most fun players to watch. He leads Sayville to a 12-0 record and another LIC for that tremendous football community. And now we're going to go to the wide receiver position. And I talked about entertaining players. This guy right here might be the most entertaining player in New York. It's KJ Duff of St. Anthony's. The 3-star recruit has colleges knocking on the door constantly, and that's for good reason. At 6'4", you can line him up anywhere, on the outside or the slot. Duff continuously made plays. When you throw it up to him, KJ Duff is coming down with it, but in the slot, he could catch the ball in traffic or take it all the way to the house each and every time. And we're going to go into Suffolk County here for the next two wide receivers. And we're going to start off with Jack Malore of Smithtown West. And we talked about that Bulls offense earlier with Braden Stahl leading it at the helm. And he found Jack Malore a lot. 69 catches. That was good to break the Suffolk County record. He was constantly making plays. And these two have another year together. Watch out for that special connection next season. And for my final receiver on the list, Anthony Morioni of Sayville had a phenomenal senior campaign. He is definitely one of the shiftiest wide receivers in New York because every time he got the ball, he was a threat to take it to the house. And when you also threw it up to him, he had the ability to jump over his defender and come down with it. He did a great job high-pointing the ball, and he was one of the best wide receivers on Long Island. And now we're going to go to my top three athletes, guys who did it both on offense and defense, special teams, you name it. They got it done. And we're going to start off with one of the best players in the tri-state area for sure. It's Ian Strong of St. Anthony's. And the Rutgers commit put on a show his senior year. We'll start off with what he did on defense. He played safety. He played linebacker. He was a big factor on why the Friars had a good run defense towards the end of the year. He also did his thing at DB, and he won Catholic League Defensive Player of the Year. But on offense, really was the entertaining part. Because at wide receiver, at 6'5", when you throw it up to Ian Strong, he is coming down with it. His duo with KJ Duff was absolutely special. He had over 800 yards as a receiver, and he'll be doing great things at Rutgers. And speaking of highly recruited players, let's go to Josiah the Jet Brown of Holy Trinity. And Brown really showcased his speed all year. He's one of the fastest players in the country. As he did his thing at wide receiver, when he got the ball, it was dangerous. Because he can go to the end zone at any given moment because of how fast he is. And then also at safety, he covered so much ground. Time and time again, Brown had some amazing touchdown-saving tackles. And of course, he's a very hard hitter. And for my final athlete on the list, it was a guy that really did everything and took Lindenhurst to having a great season. It's Chris Carson. He played defensive back, wide receiver. He took some snaps at quarterback. He showed his ability to run the football. He did pretty much everything. Carson was a finalist for the Hansen Award for good reason, and he made some key plays down the stretch. He was a big reason why Lindenhurst beat Smithtown West in the playoffs, as he had a pick six, which was really game-changing, but he really did a little bit of everything, and he'll be doing amazing things as a Stony Brook baseball commit. And now we're going to go to the offensive line. And there were some really big, talented guys throughout the island this year. We're going to start off with Mason Dietrich of Chaminade. At 6'4", 275 pounds, Dietrich is able to play anywhere on the offensive line. But at the center position, he led a stout Flyers O-line all year long. The Fordham commit was so talented, paving holes for the run game. Also a really solid pass protector. And now, we're going to take a look at one of the nastiest offensive linemen on Long Island within Sebastian Regis. Because Regis, his power and explosiveness was crazy, to say the least, during his junior year. He helped East Islip a lot on offense, as he was just simply throwing people around. And now we're going to stay in Suffolk County, and we're going to go to the Zellner Award winner. It's Ryan Amato of William Floyd. And Amato showed some great agility. He was an amazing pulling guard for the Colonials, but he also just threw people out of the way like it was nothing. Amato was a pancake machine, and he was a big reason why Floyd had one of the best ground games on the island. And speaking of tremendous ground games being led by offensive linemen, we're going to go out to Nassau County because Vincent Petzold opened up the middle of the field like no other. Petzold out of Plain Edge had a tremendous sophomore year, but during his junior year, he took the next step. He showed why he's one of the best O-linemen in New York, as he constantly was pancaking defenders left and right. Everybody, thank you so much for tuning into my video. Make sure you follow me on social media at Uzzi Sports on TikTok and Instagram, and then Twitter at Jared_Valluzzi. Everybody, once again, have a great night. I'm Jared Valluzzi. Always compete.